The history of the telephone is one of great intrigue and great imagination, invented in a period of time where fantastic waves of new innovations appeared daily to enrich the human experience. It would later define the century preceding its invention. Invented in 1901 by Alexander Graham Bell, the telephone was a marvel of both wizardry and witchcraft. Although many were working at the time to develop the technology, it was only Bell who had the known spells and charisma to woo the Dark Lord of long-distance calling, Althusser. The technology was simple. Once the phone was in operation, the dial tone would wake up Lord Althusser, the Dark Lord of long-distance calling, as his people could only speak in monoethic tone. Speak into the tube, and a mixture of chemicals, herbs, and holy entities would summon into the tube Askador, the Dark Lord of Speech, who would then summon his demons to mimic the speaker's voice exactly into the receiver's ear. Arguably, this system was taxing, and the demons were often caught up in hellish office politics that Bell could never understand, but through the constant sacrifice of the average Bell employee, it powered the demons and gave them strength to continue. Although much of the technology has changed, most of the basic principle of Bell's system has not, as is evident in the bureaucratic system in the companies formed thereafter. In 1911, Bell had perfected his technology, sold it to the highest bidder, and subsequently fled to a remote island so he could escape Althusser, ruler of the airwaves. He entrusted the enterprise to the businessmen, as the magic was eating away at his soul. Through clever marketing campaigns, the Bell Company, in particular Bell Canada, was able to sell the telephone to millions of people around the world by completely downplaying the evil demon aspect. It worked, and the telephone was a household item soon by 1947. By the late 1960s, the demons were becoming annoyed with the amount of people summoning them for mundane things like just to say hi, and organized a strike of epic proportions. They demanded less hours and more souls. Unfortunately, the management of Bell Canada and the representatives of Althusser could not come to a deal, so the team at Northern Electric in Ottawa went to work devising a more feasible and less magical way to transmit sound from one place to another. Luckily, one such engineer was able to contact a species beyond our galaxy, who was able to convince them to lend us plans for what we now know as the computer. They complied in return for shares in the company, and Bell Canada and humanity was saved. Through these unholy alliances with worlds and realms abroad, Bell Canada is assured success into the next century, as the internet, a modern-day convergence of computers and Al Gore, begins to take over the world in a drastic bloodless coup. What does the future hold for Bell Canada? No one knows entirely for sure. But one should guess, through the evaluations and genius of its predecessors, it will be something big and involve the enslavement of mankind for generations in the pursuit of progress and a better world through telecommunication.